Hello and welcome to the 2 minute series. The topic for today is food chain as well as food web. A very simple concept, but you need to understand it. Questions on this is what have been asked in UPSC prelims previously also, and any day your question is what you can expect. Now, simply, you have understood till now what are the different trophic levels. I told you that there are three levels, primarily autotrophs, phagotrophs, as well as saprotrophs. Now, these trophic levels do not exist in isolation. Rather, they are continuously exchanging energy within themselves. They are associated to each other. So, this process of transfer of energy from one trophic level to the next trophic level is what is known as a food chain. In simple terms, the producer, that is the plant, is what is eaten by the primary consumer. This primary consumer is what is consumed by the secondary consumer, then by the tertiary consumer, then by the final consumer, and finally the saprophytes are taking this final consumer. So this is how a food chain is what is being developed. So this is what is the transfer of energy from the plant to the primary consumer. So this is how energy is moving, and eventually energy is again being utilized. So the cycle is what is going on, and this is what refers to food chain. Now, a food chain again does not exist in silos. All the food chains are what are intermixed. This plant is not only eaten by one primary consumer, there are many primary consumers who are eating this particular plant. Then there are many secondary consumers who are eating these primary consumers. So it is all very much mixed up, and as a result of which this forms a something of a web. So this interconnected collection of different food chains is what is known as a food web. So this is the food chain as well as food web. This is the entire concept. Also, sometimes UPSC has a tendency to ask that you have to arrange different organisms in the food chain. So what is important is that you should be able to identify that which will be the producer, which will be the primary consumer, which will be the secondary consumer. So these kind of questions are what have been asked in the past, and anytime a repetition is what can be expected. So please practice few of such kind of questions also. So that's about food chain and food web, and that's about our discussion today. I thank you all for watching the video.